My name is Frédis Hamre, and I'm a product owner at itslearning, working with engineering teams to design and improve our tools and features. Over the past year, we've built a new survey tool to replace the old one, which is getting outdated, both in look and feel and on the technology side. In this video, I want to take you through the most important features in the new tool and show you some of the great improvements we've made. The new survey tool is obviously both accessible and mobile friendly, and it has a design aligned with the rest of the platform using modern components. Already from the start, you notice that survey now looks and behaves like other elements in itslearning. In general, we've improved the workflows a lot, making it easier and faster to work with, also if you're using the keyboard only. There are four question types to choose from: open answer, yes and no, multiple choice, and matrix. Simply type your question and save. When creating a multiple choice or matrix question, you will find a list of predefined answer alternatives that you can use to save time. They can be edited and tailored to your needs. When you're done, using Save and New will skip a few steps and give you a new question of the same type with the same answer alternatives, or you could quickly change them. This makes it super quick to create several similar questions. The normal save will take you back to the question list, and so will cancel. Questions can be reordered by simply dragging the handle on the left-hand side. This is also possible to do with the keyboard. Navigate to the handle, hit space, and use the arrow keys to move. Hit space again to drop the question in its new position. Once you're done with your survey, you can review all the questions. At the top of the view, anyone responding to the survey will see a nice progress bar to tell them how far along they are. Should you find any typos while going through the preview, there is a shortcut to edit that question and then simply return to where you left off. As with other newer element types in itslearning, new surveys can be shared in the library. This way, it can easily be reused by yourself or others. If I make this an external survey, I get an option to share it. You can share the link to the survey by copying the link itself or by copying the QR code and paste it anywhere you like for easy access. Once the responses start coming in, you can see them in this list, where you can open each one to see that particular response. In an anonymous survey such as this, there will obviously not be any names shown. You can see when they submitted, and if you allowed submission after a deadline, late submissions are indicated in the notes. In this example, someone also started the survey without completing it. That's the top row here. However, it's often more important to get the overview of the results. You can find this in the summary tab. For open answer questions, the answers are simply listed. For multiple choice and yes and no, you will see a progress bar for each option, and for matrix questions, there is a color pattern to indicate the popularity of options. There are numbers to explain, and this is also read sensibly with a screen reader. Finally, we've removed all the outdated export options and replaced them with one modern Excel export, where you will find both questions and answers in the same pattern as is now used in Test Tool. This makes it easy to create your own statistics or combine answers if you're running the same survey in another course. The documentation for the new survey tool is already available on our support pages. Feel free to check it out. You will also find information about the migration process for existing surveys there, and we'll keep the pages updated as we make future improvements. Thanks for watching!